at a store. Gina, that's what I'm talking about, baby. I told you it was short. That's how short it was, baby. It's going down right here. Street Beats is on your radio with your boy, Mr. Steve-O, a.k.a. Mr. Outstanding. That's right, man. And hey, it's about that time, man. I got my spotlight one-on-one interview. That's right, man. I got my boy, the hot seat, Texas A&M quarterback, Jerrod Johnson. What's up with it, dog?
Man, what's up, Steve-O, man? I'm doing good.
That's what's up, man. I appreciate you coming out. I'm over here taking time out of your busy schedule. I know you just coming back in from out of town, so you already know, man. Real quick, I wanted to say congratulations, of course, on surviving through another spring season, you know, practices now. You know, at this point, though, man, I guess, how do you see the Aggies, though, man, you know, looking, going into the fall season, though, man?
I mean, we look pretty good, you know. We had a lot of young guys last year, you know, and I think everybody matured a little bit, and with the real tough spring and winter, you know, Coach Sherman definitely, you know, wanted to strengthen our mental toughness, so we came together as a team, and everything's going to be real good.
And I understand, though, man. I know y'all had a lot of injuries, though, injuries right here during the spring. I mean, I kept up with it, man. I know I'm an Aggie fan, Aggie festival. I believe the maroon and white, though, man. Every time we go out there to Corpus Christi, though, man, there ain't nothing but horn fans out there, though, man. But I believe maroon and white, though, man.
Oh, really?
We get ankles all the time, but we don't trip, baby. You already know, man. Now, real quick, though, man, look. I know you have a deadly weapon, man, in Jeff Fuller. I'm going to let you know this right now. Jeff is a beast, man. He's a beast out there, though, man. He's a beast now. With him, of course, and Ryan Tannehill, man, they probably seem to be, you know, A&M's best, in my opinion, A&M's best, you know, receiving tandem since, I believe, Bethel Johnson and Terrence Murphy were, you know, here back here in a few years ago, though, man. But I guess right now, I guess, did you think, though, man, they were going to develop, you know, and adjust to the college level as quick as they did, though, man, seeing that they're only going to be sophomores next season?
I mean, I knew they were both good, you know, Jeff the Beast, you know, Ryan, you know, he came as a quarterback, and he still is a real good quarterback, you know, he's just a real good football player, but, you know, I was surprised, you know, they picked everything up so well, you know, and they both did real good, and Jeff, like I said, the Beast, you know, he's a man of my voice.
That's what it looks like. I mean, that, you took the words right out of my mouth. He plays like that, though, man. He plays like a beast out there, so big shout-out, of course, to Jeff, though, man. Now, look, of course, the NFL draft was this weekend, though, man. I guess, first of all, I want to know, who is your favorite NFL team, though, period? Just who is your favorite NFL team before we go into the draft?
I'm definitely a Texas fan. I'm humble North Side of Houston, so I got to go
with
my Texas.
You're a Texas fan, no matter. So were you ever an Oilers fan? I'm assuming that you were an Oilers fan.
I mean, I was kind of young, you know. My parents definitely had me some Oilers stuff going on.
I think I got a partner right there. I got one of those old Oilers sweatshirts that he used to wear. It's tight as hell on him, nobody. He don't even dress, though, man. So you a Texas fan, though. So with that being said, though, man, I guess, how do you think the Texans did in the draft, though, man?
I mean, I think they did pretty good. You know, the Texans, I guess, Kubiak is definitely going on keeping a strong defense. You know, we definitely got our first couple picks, you know, the last couple years off the defensive players. You know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, I guess that's how you win championships, the defense.
And he's going to that line. I know last year he picked the youngster, the real youngster. Who was,
yeah, Louisville.
And then he got Mario Williams, of course, the year before, though, man. Now, look, of course, we had a couple of fighting Texas Aggies, though, man, get drafted today, though, man. Congratulations out there. Of course, talk about, of course, Stephen McGee, though, man, Mike Goodson, though. Have you talked to them after the draft selection in the fourth round?
I sent both of them texts. You know, I'm sure they had a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, but, no, Steve's a great player. You know, it's kind of expected for us. You know, we all know Steve's real good. You know, it wasn't that big of a surprise for us, you know, and, I know he's happy to be at home. He's a real big family guy, and I know he's happy to be with the Cowboys. And,
that's right, man.
And Mike, you know, I think this is the best situation for Mike, was going to Carolina. You know, they have two real good running backs as it is, and so I think it's going to help him in the long run.
He's gonna gain that experience, though, man. That's exactly what it is. So.
Yeah, from a durability standpoint, you know, he's going to be the third down guy, do a lot of screens, stuff like that. So I think he can help his longevity. So I mean, they both got real good situations.
That's right, man. That's right, though. So big shout outs also to Stephen McGee. Big shout outs to all the Aggies, though, out there, though, of course. I know there's going to be some out there signing as free agents, though, man. No doubt about it, though. So I want to send shout-outs also to Michael Bennett, of course, Jaborski Lane, and the whole Fighting Texas Aggie team, though, man. Hey, right now, we're about to get into it right here. My boy, you going to stick around here for a few more minutes?
Yeah, I'll be here for a while.
All right, man. We're going to parlay right here, me and my boy Jerrod. You know how we do it, baby. It's Aggie Land's Party Station. Street Beats is on your radio right now. We're getting into it. Hey, this is Brazos Valley's very own Puttin'. The song is called Haters in My Rear View. It's going down right here on Aggie Land's Party Station, baby. We're 101.9 The Beat.